हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू बीटेक फर्स्ट ईयर फिजिक्स कोर्स। नाउ टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द कंजर्वेशन लॉज ऑफ सिस्टम ऑफ पार्टिकल्स। नाउ इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट कंजर्वेशन लॉज ऑफ सिंगल पार्टिकल, राइट। नाउ दिस कंजर्वेशन लॉज ऑफ सिस्टम ऑफ पार्टिकल आई हैव डिवाइडेड इनटू टू लेक्चर्स। सो इन द पार्ट वन I shall discuss about concept of external and internal forces, then center of mass and conservation of linear momentum. Okay, so let's proceed. Now in this lecture I have written many lines. I have done it deliberately because when I talk, so that you can read from the slide and try to understand also. Okay, so I will give you the idea what is the thing, and many things are written over here. You can also read from here and you can understand. So that's why I have kept this. Okay, so external and internal force, what does this mean? So when we talk about system of particles, now if we apply external force on the system of particles, we have to consider the external force, also the internal force which are inside the system of particle, when we talk about the total force which are in the system. Okay, so here this FIE, that is the, so here we are talking about system of particles, means there are number of particles, large number of particles. So in this case we can consider a system which have n particles. So I means the ith particle, an arbitrary particle, and the index is I. Okay, so the Fi here, this Fi means the total force which is on ith particle of the system, and Fie means the external force which is applied on that ith particle. Now what is this term, summation over j equal to 1 to n Fij? Now let's understand this. So Fij is the internal force. You can see it is written over here. Fij is the internal force on the ith particle due to the jth particle. Means, suppose here if we do this summation, it will be Fi1 F plus Fi2 plus Fi3, like that. Means if I consider I equal to 1, suppose the first particle, so in that case your j, you are actually considering from 2 to n. Means F12 means the internal force which is applied on the first particle due to the second particle, that is F12. Now F13, that is the internal force on the first particle due to the third particle. Okay, in this way we have to do this summation. Okay, now I think you can understand. So Fji, if I tell Fji, what does this mean? That will be the internal force on the jth particle due to the ith particle, right? Okay, now as there are n number of particles, we have to consider the total, all the numbers, n numbers of particles, right? Now here Fii means the force of the ith particle on itself, that is naturally zero, right? So a particle that will not exert any other internal force on itself, that will be zero. So Fii, that is zero. Okay, now this Fi, that is the total force, we can write like this, that is the time derivative of the momentum, linear momentum on the ith part of the ith particle, and we can write like this. Okay, so in the left side we are writing this term, you can see. So here we are doing the summation over I, means we want to see the total effect on the system. So there are number of particles, so I will vary. So when we talk about internal force, we are fixing the particle and we are seeing the effect of other particles on that ith particle. Now we are seeing the total system, and the total system is consisted of such different number of ith particle. So there will be a summation over I to see the total effect on the system. So that's why we have done this. And here you should see one important thing, that here when we are doing this summation Fij and summation over I and summation over j, so there I is not equal to j. Means if I consider I equal to 1, then your j will be vary from 2 to n. Now if you consider the I equal to 2, then your j will be 1, 3, then up to n, like that. So that's why this I not equal to j term is there, because you can understand that f ii term is 0, right? Okay. Now, so this internal force is basically will be 0, this total term. Why? Because there will be term Fij, also Fji. Now how you will understand? So when we do this sum, you will get F12. One term you will get F12. Now another term you can get F21. So F12, you know, the internal force on first particle due to the second particle, and F21 is the internal force on second particle due to the first particle. So both will be opposite in direction, because due to the Newton's third law. Okay, so that's why Fij plus Fji is 0. Now if we use this term will be 0, and we are left with this term. So this Fe is the total external force which is applied on the system. Okay. Now let's understand the center of mass. Already you know what is center of mass. Let me recap this thing. The definition of center of mass we can write like this. So summation over MIRI, and then you have to divide by the total mass of the system, right? And this r is the distance of the center of mass from the center, okay, and m is the total mass of the system. Now we know this, already we have obtained. Now if we use this concept m in capital M into r here, then we will get this, and it will be MACM. ACM is the acceleration of the center of mass, that is due to that external force which is applied on the system. Now what does this mean? This means that the center of mass of the system moves in such a way, if we consider another particle, a particle of same mass of your system, then we can easily understand the dynamics of the system. So what I want to mean, that how your CM, means center of mass, is moving, that is actually similar kind of thing, that you are considering a particle of same mass and it is moving due to that external force. Okay. So as if total mass is centered on the center of mass and it is moving, and if we understand the dynamics of that CM, we can understand the dynamics of the total system. Okay. Now let's see the conservation of linear momentum of system of particles. So you can see here I can multiply this m here, and if we take the time derivative, it will be like this. So we are considering there as n number of particles. Now this dr dt is v. So what is this capital V? Capital V is the velocity of the center of mass with respect to the center, that center O, which we are this center O. Okay. Now this will be m1v1 plus m2v2 sum and up to mnvn, and this is the summation over MIVI and I varies from I to N. Okay, so this summation is actually called the total linear momentum of the system, and we can write that is actually mass into the velocity, and this mass is the total mass of the system and velocity is the velocity of the center of mass. So you can easily understand that if we multiply the mass of the system and with that velocity of the center of mass, we can tell this is the linear momentum of the system, right? So that is important. Now if we take the time derivative, it will be like this, okay? So it will be like this. Now if the external force is zero, then we can easily tell that this mass into the velocity of the center of mass or summation over MIVI, individual mass of the particles and velocity of the particle, that will be constant. So this is the conservation of linear momentum of the system of particles. Okay. Now I shall tell you one important concept of center of mass frame of reference. Now what does this mean? Please listen carefully. So reference frame, what is reference frame? So when we measure some position or velocity in classical mechanics, so always we measure that position or velocity with respect to a universal frame or a universal origin. Okay, so basically when you calculate the velocity of a particle in your 11th class, there this term is not written over there with respect to which frame. Obviously there is a frame with respect to which you are measuring the velocity. So that frame is a inertial frame, maybe it is a absolute inertial frame. You know that there are two types of frame that we call as inertial frame and non-inertial frame. So the frames which have a constant velocity with respect to each other, that is called the inertial frame. Now if a frame which have a acceleration, that is non-inertial frame. We will discuss this thing later on, what will be the effect in non-inertial frame. Okay, so now here we can measure the velocity of the center of mass with respect to two frames. Now how are you construct that two frame? Try to understand this. Now suppose we are considering a experiment, and that experiment is minimum. So to define the center of mass, we require minimum two particle, right? So suppose two particle is actually colliding with each other. Okay, so see this left side figure. So this is a particle which is actually colliding with this bigger particle. So what will be the center of mass of this system? And that center of mass, obviously it will change its position, okay, as this MA is moving. And this we are seeing from a reference frame, that is called the laboratory reference frame or laboratory coordinate system, that is called lab frame. Lab frame means we are considering a frame which is in the laboratory. That means if you consider a room, and that reference frame is the corner of that room. With respect to that, what is happening for this center of mass, how that center of mass is moving. Now if we consider a center of mass which is we consider a reference frame which is on this center of mass, so what we will see? So here in the left side figure, the observer is in the laboratory frame, but in the right side figure we are considering the observer is on the center of mass. So wherever is the observer, that is actually your reference frame. Okay, so as the observer is on center of mass, this is the center of mass frame. Okay, now here in the left side picture, we can see that the center of mass has a particular velocity. because this particle is moving as a whole, the center of mass will move. But here, what we will see, you imagine like that, you are here and two particles are coming towards you. You are on the center of mass and two particles are coming towards you. That means your center of mass is actually not moving. So, in the center of mass frame, the center of mass is basically in rest. The center of mass velocity with respect to the center of mass frame is zero. That is very obvious. Okay? So, as a result, the linear momentum in the center of mass frame, that will also be zero. That's why we are writing this thing. So, this frame is also called zero momentum frame. And please, here one important thing is there is no external force. Obviously, there is no external force. That's why this is happening. So, this type of concept is important in some cases when we talk about particle physics, when we talk about the collision between two particles. Okay, so in that aspect, this type of concept is important to analyze the center of mass frame dynamics. Okay, we can analyze the whole process basically if we consider the center of mass frame reference. Okay, so please keep it in mind. Okay, now here I am ending this part. Now in the next part, I will discuss about conservation laws of energy of system of particles. Okay, thank you.